And really, I want to conduct your worship. And really, I am enjoying being here and to see you all once again. I'm no more a guest. And I feel you all my family.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And I thank Pastor Vijay and Pastor Sureka for inviting me. And also, I thank one and all, and especially my sister Cheryl always. I will be encouraged by her and by their family. And here, each one of you, you are really a great strength for me. This year, I'm really missing Sister June. But one thing I can say surely, now she is with the Lord. And what all she has done in this world, and all her pain and everything, now she has received a peace and rest in the presence of God.
Amen.
So she ran her race, and she could finish her race successfully.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And this morning, and I bring greetings from my church back home, Saint Fellowship. I have a senior pastor, Reverend Mohan Babu, and all the leaders, they send their greetings to the church here. And we had a wonderful time last week with Pastor Vijay and Pastor Sureka. Everybody there, they're all blessed by their ministry. And I have another desire also about the church here. Not only pastor's family, even others also, you are all invited to India. You are all most welcome to India, and you can come and minister there, and then you will find the need of ministry, how God is moving in other places. That will certainly, that is going to help you. Hallelujah. So this morning, God, He wants to touch each one of us, and He's saying a great miracle is awaiting for us, and that is we can receive only from God. And always God, He wants to remind us about His plan on our lives, because as an individual, as a family, and about our nation, God is saying He has great plan. Always He wants to reveal the plan to His people. He doesn't want to hide the plan from us, but He is very much eager to reveal His plan to us. And this morning, and God is saying, at this hour of our world, we are finding lot of havoc and a lot of need in this world. Everywhere we are finding lot of things are happening which are really shaking this world. And world is in crisis, and we are seeing many problems around the world. Like recently we heard about France and other things also. In every continent or all nations, everybody, they are troubled by many things. So when we are going through all these crises here, what way we can approach to God, or what is the heart of God about this world for the present days? That is what God, He wants us to find out from Him. As a church, when we have gathered like this, then certainly that is our responsibility to know the answer for the present situation. Do we have an answer for the present situation? So everywhere people, they caught up with fear, and they were confused, and they are saying, what is going to happen later? Or else everybody, they are very much troubled about the things what are going around. But here, in all the whatever that is happening in this world, in the midst of our trouble, we have a great hope in our living God. Hallelujah. We have a hope. We have a hope. No need to give up things. But God is saying, let not your heart be trouble. When we look unto Him, then certainly we are going to receive peace. Many times what is happening in this world, when we can find that really troubles us about our families, about our neighborhood, about our cities, and slowly we are catching that disturbance and we are losing peace within ourselves. And this morning God is saying, some of you, you may not be having peace in your heart. You are very much troubled. But here, God has an answer for all our problems. And we should influence this world. We should not be influenced by the world outside. So, everywhere we find lot of disturbances. Whatever that is causing the disturbance, here God wants to reveal some of the things, the place what God has about our lives, that certainly that will be an answer for the world what we are seeing now. We have an answer for this present world. Hallelujah. So everything we can find from the Bible. So this Bible that is for past, present and for the future. So outside this Bible we cannot find anything. Everything that has revealed through the Word of God and that has given to us and that is in our hands. And we have a solution. We can find a solution. And this morning, God is reminding about His plan from Jeremiah 29:11, saying, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil." Always, God is looking at us and to bless us. And He is looking for our welfare. And the plan what we have on our lives, God is saying, that is the high calling. In Philippians 3rd chapter 14th verse, we can find, and we have a race set before us. We are supposed to look at the goal and we should accomplish and we should complete our task. And we should run a race so that we achieve that goal. So, whatever the goal that is set before us, that is a high call that we can receive from God. And for each one of us, if we can find the calling what God has about our lives, then that will be set as a goal before us to achieve through our lives. Without a goal, a person's life, that will be like a void. Living in this world, just for nothing, that is just a waste. But God has created the whole thing with a purpose. So recently, I was teaching in the Bible college back home about the doctrines. And I'm very much enjoyed teaching the doctrines of several things, like example, doctrine of God. When I'm teaching about the doctrine of God, always we should know the truth. That is the foundation of our faith. So, in doctrine of God, and I was teaching about the triune God as the God of Father, God of Son, and God of Holy Spirit. And here, when we talk about God, always we should know God, He is a creator. No one has created God, but the whole thing created by God. So He is a creator, and everything apart from God, that we can say creature or created by God. And when God has created the whole universe, heaven and earth, there we can find His plan within His creation. And He has a heart for His creation. And when God created, we can find everything that was good. So, sometimes whatever we are seeing in the creation, that may not be the same what God has created. But whatever it may be, but always God's plan is eternal. No one can change the plan of God. One may go astray from the plan, but they cannot change the mind of God and the nature of God. And we can attribute many things to God. And He is highly exalted, and there is none in this world or above this world matching to the God or His majesty. He is King of Kings, Lord of Lords. And we can see many things, but no, this is not a class to again talking about the doctrine of God. But I'm just referring some of the points. And also, I taught about the origin of Saturn and demonology. And our students back home, they were so interested to know the origin of Saturn. Are you interested to know the origin of Saturn?
Yes.
We are very fearful about Saturn. But knowing about Saturn and the work of the Saturn, always that will be interesting, because we have something to do with the activities of the enemy. And always enemy, he wants people to meddle in their lives. So here, and also about the origin of Saturn and demonology, I will just give few points, because later what I am going to speak, that depends on the subject or on the point of Saturn. So, origin of Saturn that we can find from the Bible, from the book of Ezekiel 28:12-18, there he was called as Lucifer, and he was an anointed guardian cherub. Was an exalted and a highly, he was in a great position, and he was an anointed one, created by God, placed on the holy mountain of God. He was, once he was blameless, beautiful, and full of wisdom. His name was Lucifer. But what happened? When he looked to himself, and he was very much proud about himself, and he started rebel against God. In Isaiah 14:12-15, we can find the way he rebelled against God, and he had a different understanding and about himself. And he said to himself, "I will set my throne on high." See, God has already elevated him, and he was in a high position, but still he was not happy about what God has given him. And he himself, he wants to elevate more than God. And here we find five ways he wants to elevate him. He kept saying, "I will, I will, I will, I will, I will." And second, he said, "I will sit on the mountain of assembly. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds, and I will ascend to heaven. I will make myself like the Most High." When he rebelled against God, then he was whatever he expected, it didn't happen. But he was thrown from the heaven, from the highest place. So whoever, all the angels, they were following Lucifer, they were also fell from the highest place, in from heaven. And for them, we can call as demons or demonic powers. So all the angels and those who were in the presence of God, they were created by God. But when they rebelled against God, they have lost the nature of God, and their powers, whatever they were given, they started using them against God's will. So sometimes we may not say Satan, he doesn't have any power. He has power, not more than God. He has power, that's not for a welfare of our lives. That's not for good thing. But he's using his abilities to go against the will of God for destruction and to harm. But God's power, that is totally different. Always his will, that will be like heaven. And the will of the enemy or Satan, that created hell. So we can find two types, totally different. One is from God and the other is from the enemy. So living on this world, then if we know what is existing, then if we can understand that, our lives can be benefited by knowing some of the things and having the knowledge of things what all around us. That certainly that will protect us and to help our lives. So, and also activities of Satan and his angels to destroy, kill, and to steal. And he wants to destroy the creation of God. And he wants to steal peace. And he wants to, he lie. And he created many lies in this world to deceive people. He always go around the world and make people to get deceived by his nature. And he makes people to believe all lies. And the people in this world, if they do not know the truth, certainly they will be deceived by the enemy. And also he diverts people to rebel against God and causing them to go to hell. So always we should be beware of Satan and his angels. And we should know how to get protection from God. That is very, very important. And also when we look at the creation, God has created man and woman among the creation in a great level. He created man and woman in his image and he blessed them. So always his creation, that is for blessing, because all blessings that belongs to God. So what all God has created, always that will be a great blessing. So in Genesis 1:28 it says, he blessed them and said to them, be fruitful and multiply, fill the earth and subdue it. Mankind was designed to do the will of God and to worship and to serve him and also to glorify God and to live with God for eternity in heaven. So when God created human beings or man and woman, they are destined to go to heaven, to live forever with the living God. What a great plan God has. So, man is an eternal being. So, he is a spirit. As when we talk about God, he is a spirit. So, when God created man in his image, he kept the spirit in man so that he became a living creature. So Adam and Eve deceived by Satan and lost their life, and they were dead in spirit and lost their fellowship with God. So that sin made them to get separated from God, and the enemy became the ruler of this world. In John 14, 30 it says, when Jesus was speaking and said, I have nothing to do with the ruler of this world, because he was under the rulership and authority of his father. But God has created, but God has a great plan about mankind. Through Jesus, his son, he wants to restore everything back. Though man gone astray, but he wants to restore people. So in this world, no religion has power to restore mankind back to their original status. Every person in this world wants to make themselves to set right with God. This world, they are not able to know the reality. Whatever they have imagined and they themselves, they have different ideas about God. But whatever the ideas as man had in this world, we cannot say everything is true. But Satan is a liar. And he wants to divert away from God and to lead their lives into deceit and in lie. So, even as Christians, we may be going to church from our childhood and we may grown in Christianity, and we think being a Christian, knowing Jesus as God, that's enough. But as a religion, that will do, it doesn't do any good. But having fellowship with God, because when Jesus, he came to this world, he wants to restore human or this world again back to God. Everything will be restored only through the redemption of Jesus. Through one man, Adam, the condemnation was brought and the death manifested in this world. So, Jesus was called as the second Adam, and through Jesus, life came into the mankind. Hallelujah. So, just having some religious activities and rituals, it doesn't make a man to get restored back to God, but only by the act of Jesus, what he has done, that makes a person to get connected to God. That is very, very important. I raised as a Christian, but at my age of 22 years, I came to know this truth. That day, I made a decision. That day, it made me to get restored with God, and fellowship started with God, and I was having that fellowship, and I could know what God has planned for me. In spite of save a person, Jesus taking the place of man through his incarnation, that's a very, very important word. Incarnation means God, the Son, Jesus, taking the form of man. There, in incarnation, God and man, we can see, united. And he came to this world as a boy. When he born in this world, he was totally different from other people, because everybody, they have the blood from their ancestors, that continuation of sinful nature. But Jesus, he was holy. His blood was uncorruptible blood. He born to Virgin Mary. So, we know the signs, and we can say he didn't have an earthly father. Just to come under the lineage of David, his name was written under the statistics that about as a son of Joseph, but before he born in this world, he was in heaven. So he came to this world, and in Jesus there was no guilt, and totally we can see here. Please notice one thing: when Jesus came to this world, he had a big test. He had to prove himself to take the burden of his kingdom. So to take up the burden, first he should be proved himself that he is obeying his father. So when he was growing as a child, around him he had many challenges to disobey his father. But always Jesus was saying, I know, I must obey my father. I must do the will of my father. Very clearly he knew about his plan, purpose about his life in this world. When you know the plan of God, that itself that will help us to live according to God's plan. If one is not aware of God's plan, they cannot be questioned, or they cannot be achieve anything in this world. So Jesus, he knew at the age of 12 years, he could say, I'm on my father's job. What a wonderful statement he could make with his parents. So he was going through all the tests, but he was successful. He was not obeying or disobeyed his father, and by 30 years he proved himself. Anywhere he was not disobedient to his father, he came out successfully. Then father thought, now Jesus, he is suitable to take up and hold the responsibility of his kingdom. Already that was prophesied in Isaiah 9 chapter, and about prophets also we can see God wants to send his son to this world. So after 30 years, there it came to a place, very important truth is going to be declared. Then father asked him to go to the river of Jordan. There John the Baptist, when he looked at Jesus, immediately God has revealed he is the person who will be the lamp of this world. Hallelujah. And here John the Baptist, he prophesied and he said, see, here is the Lamb of God. Lamb of God. How great it is. When the prophecy declared and the calling on Jesus that has declared, now that is the responsibility of Jesus to respond to his calling, even for ourselves. Just knowing the purpose and plan of God, that's not enough. When we come to know the plan of God on our lives, that is our responsibility of how we respond to his calling. When God called me to resign my job and to serve him, I know what I have done. I had great interest about the job, what I was doing as a manufacturing chemist. Then I said, no, Lord, if you want me to serve you, I can give my free time. I started suggesting many things to God. But one thing I found, I can't change God. Can you change God? Never. Whether we have to obey or to disobey and go astray. So I was not willing to obey God, and I had a plan to accomplish in my life, that my own plan, to have a own pharmaceutical company, because 8 formulas of medicine, they were in my hand. And I was already booked in a new company as a manufacturing chemist. So my dreams were different. And those dreams were attract and pulling me to go against the plan of God. And when God was asking me to resign, it was so hard. So finally, it took 9 months to realize that. And finally, I had to I decided to obey God. That day I said, okay Lord, as you said, I will resign. Because Jesus said, first you resign, then I will show the place. I was praying, first you show me, then I will resign. But finally, I had to resign. I found I can't change God. Then, after I resigned my job, I was at home one day praying, Lord, why you ask me to resign? I don't want to stay at home. Then one letter came. Then God guided me to the right thing. Then I could find one thing. Obeying God always, that's really a great blessing. Later I found how great it is. When I tasted His goodness while working for Him, then I started praying for my sisters. I want all my sisters to have that experience. I was enjoying God's presence while doing His work. I'm seeing His mighty presence with me. I've seen God teaching me many things. Then I realized God's plan, that is always greater than our plan or my plan. Once I had a desire to become a doctor. By this time, I think I might have, what to say, designer? No. Retired. I would have retired from that job. I would have earned some money, and I would have earned some house to live, and I might have had some bank balance and other things. But now I can say, more than what I could earn by a job, now through serving God, I have received many blessings, many blessings. That is for eternity. All my friends are already retired. Now I'm 60. They're all resigned. Once I felt, why Lord, you didn't allow me to study. One day I was going to a hospital to take up a class for like a medicals and for staff. My friend came and asked me, all of a sudden, and she said, now I'm a house surgeon, what are you doing? I was ashamed. Then I felt, okay, I taught some lesson there, and two of Muslim guys, they accepted Jesus. I was happy. After going home, I rushed home and closed my door and knelt down, and I want to ask God why He didn't allow me to study medicine. After that, He would have called me for the ministry. I had great desire to study. I had great interest for studies. But my tongue turned another way, and I spoke and said, Lord, thank you for giving me this job. And I saw those two persons in my vision, and God said, I have given more than your friends. That time God said, one day they are going to resign. That is only for their livelihood. But you are serving my purposes. And that is going to last forever and ever. Hallelujah. Then later I decided myself, though I have a lot of pressure from outside to do some jobs, Then I decided I must obey God. If God has a plan for you to work in a secular sense, you should work. Don't say, because God called me, we are also supposed to resign our jobs and to get into ministry. If God didn't help you, God hasn't called you, don't do that. Wherever you are placed, be faithful for God. Whatever way He wants you to serve, be faithful to God. That is very, very important. Very, very important. And Jesus, as prophesied in the Bible, he knew he has to take up the burden of His kingdom. Now He has to respond to say yes or no. Very easily we think, he has already told yes, I think. That's not right. He has chances to say no also. He was walking towards the water to reply His father. You know what reply He had to give? He went inside the water. There, while taking baptism, He confirmed Himself to His Father, saying, I am ready to die for the whole mankind. The moment when He dipped in the water, He came out, that was showing He is going to die Himself for the world, and that He is going to be buried. He will be rising from the dead. The moment when Jesus accepted the will of His Father, He said, He is my beloved Son. Because Jesus was willing to take up the burden of His kingdom. Burden of the kingdom of His Father. Hallelujah. Then the Holy Spirit came upon Him to accomplish the will of His Father. Only flesh, it cannot accomplish the purposes of God. So, to go against the powers of darkness, here God has planned to send Holy Spirit God so that He can destroy the works of the enemy. In 1 John 3:8 it says, the Son of Man appeared to destroy the works of the enemy. Hallelujah! He came to this world to destroy the works of the enemy. Are you excited?
Yes.
How nice. There is someone who can destroy the works of the enemy. We know what are the works of the enemy. No one here want to taste the works of the enemy. But we are going through many problems, sickness, poverty, many challenges we are facing in our day-to-day life. But here, God wants to represent Himself as a savior to this world, because He is the one, He has destroyed the works of the enemy. Hallelujah! We have someone who has destroyed the works of the enemy. So, let us enjoy the goodness of God.
Amen.
How many of you want to enjoy the goodness of God?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Today, God, you are going to taste His mighty power upon your life. I am just giving the word, whatever God has kept in my mind. This word, that is not my thought. But God, He wants to deliver this truth so that He wants to do something this morning. God is at work. Please repeat that word. God is at work.
God is at work.
God is at work to destroy the works of the enemy.
To destroy the works of the enemy.
He didn't stop His job. He's still continuing His job. Many may think, now Jesus, He rose from the dead and gone back to heaven, seated at the right hand of His Father. Now no more Jesus. was a child of in our Sunday school. Yesterday we have seen many children, and they are all innocent, and they are learning about God. How great it is! Here, many people, you have come, and you are helping the children to know the truth. That will be rewarded one day. Yet, just we are appreciating and acknowledging. That's all. Yesterday, Hina, she was working hard, and she brought so many gifts. She arranged all those gifts here, and she called all the teachers and distributed their gifts to the teachers and the helpers, volunteers. All they received happily. Does anybody are angry to receive a gift? No one. Everybody will feel happy. No?
Yes.
But she couldn't prepare herself to have a gift for her own. So that had to give today by Pastor Sureka. So these gifts are just appreciation. But one day, the gift what God has for us, that is beyond our imagination. We cannot count what we are going to receive from God. Hallelujah! And this life has a great chance or to achieve something. You are given a life to achieve something during your life in this world. That will last forever and ever, ever and ever. Don't think after I go back heaven then I can work. You can work. You have to. There won't be any choice there. Because there only one choice will be there. Those who made a choice here, they can continue their choice in eternity in heaven. Keep serving God. Keep serving God. There won't be any choice not to serve God and to serve the enemy, Satan. Thank God. Then we won't find a Satan. And the history of Satan or the works of Satan that is going to put a full stop. That should be stopped one day. That is going to stop one day. We just repeat and say, the works of the Satan is going to be stopped one day.
Works of the enemy is going to be stopped one day.
You want to know how it is going to stop? Are you interested to know how the works of the enemy is going to stop? Is it possible?
Yes.
I want to find out from you. Is it possible?
Yes.
Is it?
Yes.
You're just you're the thinking that would be the right answer you have to answer. But how it will happen? So here, now I want to tell the doctrine of church. Doctrine means having the right understanding about the truths of God. That will be like a foundation. We'll have a different opinions about church around the world. Some people, they think, as Christians, we have to attend the church. We need a membership in the church. Back home, our people, really, they are very much have membership in some churches. Those who have good burial grounds, they'll find out, do you have a burial ground? Is this pastor is going to visit our family? Is he going to pray for us? Whenever we are in need, if we get some sickness or some problem, we need a pastor to serve us. And like that, different opinions. Some people, they think, recently they said, do you know, we belong to a big church. Oh, I was very happy. That's good. You are saying you belong to a big church. So, as a member of that church, what way you can say you belong to the church. What is your place in the church? What is your place in the kingdom of God? Why? Do you know what is church means? They said, no, we enjoy ourselves going every week and we hear nice message and we look around and we see many people sitting around us. We sing unto God and we give our tithes to God and we feel ourselves very holy and we go back. We'll come back. We go back. We'll come back. What we are doing? Here, God is there, wants to tell something about the church. Church emerged on the day of Pentecost through the sacrifice of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let us say hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Church is existing. That's a good news. You know what is church? Later we'll find. In Old Testament, we see the functions and ministry brought by different individuals time to time. For example, great men and women, they were used by God for special tasks like Noah, Abraham, Sarah, Moses and other people, Joseph, or many God servants are there. God has raised some as judges, kings, prophets, priests. They were appointed by God to serve His purpose. But when Jesus came to this world, all ministries put together, we can find in one person, Jesus Christ. Let us clap. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All the ministry, what all we see in Old Testament, now Jesus, that all that manifested in one person, Jesus Christ. Really, when I was meditating on that, I was very happy. I preached about about church on the day of Pentecost this year. That was in May. When I was preparing myself, when God spoke to me, I was shocked. So far, I was reading the Bible, but I couldn't find this truth about Jesus, what way He was manifested. He brought the whole ministry of His Father in a body form through Jesus. He's the high priest, He's the judge, He's the savior, and He is prophet. Everything, all the ministry of Jesus we could find in one place. After He died for us and after His resurrection, He appeared for 40 days to prove Himself to the people. His body is the same body and that has raised as immortal and glorious body. Hallelujah! Same body. Whatever man has lost, here Jesus could gain. He could conquer death. Hallelujah. He's the only one person in this world could conquer the death. How great our God is. You see, whatever God has given to man, the authority over this creation, God asked the man to take hold of this whole creation and to bring ruling into this land. But because the enemy deceived them, the authority was grabbed by the enemy. How dare he is. Do you think God, He's a God of failure? Never, never. Always He's on victory side. Though man failed, here God has planned everything back, everything to be restored through Jesus. Hallelujah. He born in this world as a man, Jesus, Now, his purpose in this world is to destroy the works of the enemy and to take back the authority of God. Hallelujah. The authority that belongs to Jesus. That has to be given to the mankind, not to the enemy. If the authority is given to the enemy, enemy always he wants to destroy. But ruling is not for destruction. Ruling is to, ruling should be done to get flourished and to have goodness and to enjoy life. Hallelujah. So authority is very important. I want to tell one secret. Where there is authority always, the enemy tries to grab that authority. And slowly, he will try to make the person to come his side, not to the side of God. Not only authority means don't think only up to church or some Christian organization. But whatever the authority we find in this world, every authority that is from God. Once I was thinking about a leader of our state, I was thinking that chief minister is not a good person. And I was thinking against about him. Immediately God stopped and said, that's not right. You should not think against him. Lord, do you know that about that person? As if he doesn't know. I was saying, he's a murderer. He worships dead bodies. Because whatever the news I gathered, I was telling, I want to inform God. God said, he would have been a believer. God's servant, my servant. But he is continuing in his whole life. That is the failure of the church. Failure of the church. I had to shut my mouth. I had to shut my thoughts. What? How? Because God said, at that time, whatever he was given, that's my will for him. But my will is for him to rule this land as a believer. But church is not active and not realizing their responsibility and power. That's why he doesn't know the Lord. So since then, I learned this lesson. Even we should not talk against our teachers. Any in our offices, we should not think against about our boss, officers, anybody. Though they are not a believer, then also we should not speak against any ruler or any person who is in authority. We should honor the authorities. We should respect. Here, parents, you please teach your children to respect their people. Even children has to respect their mother and father because they are the people. They are given authority and to look after the children. Children, they should realize. So, before ascending to heaven, he commanded his disciples to tarry for the promise given by his Father about the Holy Spirit. And the disciples and other around 120, they gathered in a upper room, we know. Then, when they were praying earnestly in the presence of God with one accord, and something happened after the 50 days of passed after his resurrection. On the 50th day, that is the feast of Pentecost, that day something fantastic happened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon those who were praying. All of a sudden, we can see in Acts 2nd chapter. All then, What happened, you know? Whatever the ministry totally pulled, that was pulled, Jesus had, everything that has distributed the people in that group, they were given responsibilities or talents, gifts of the Holy Spirit, spread over the people in that place. And all put together, they are now one body of Christ. Hallelujah! Jesus has only one body. So, he became the head of mankind. How great he is. Becoming a man, that was really very, very important. He became a man so that he could become the head of the church and to take hold of the responsibilities of his body. So church is the body functioning of Jesus Christ. Bodily functioning. So when they are given responsibilities and they came to know their calling, with oneness they were working as a body. With the apostolic leadership, when they have started the ministry, there we can see that started increasing day by day. Hallelujah. So, though the church has spread over the continents in different places, anywhere in this world, we can say, all put together, we can say, universal church of the body of Christ. Hallelujah. So, for the convenience and to for our like working purpose, God has given small groups locally so that we can have the we have to function as the body of Christ. In Ephesians 1st chapter 22-23, there we find he is seated on the right hand of his Father. So the church is the body of Christ, the fullness of him who fills all in all. As a man, Jesus has taken back the authority on heaven and on earth. Hallelujah. Jesus has taken back the authority. Now, his body is present in this world. Though he is on heaven, he had to go to heaven because to establish his authority, he has to sit on a higher place. He lifted to a higher place. That shows he conquered everything. So from there, from his highest place, now he is functioning through his body in this world to destroy the works of the enemy. Hallelujah. So the authority, whatever that has taken back by Jesus, now that is released to the church and to destroy the works of the enemy. Those who accept Jesus and they take baptism, you know what the importance of baptism? Here, while taking baptism, they are identifying themselves in the body of Christ, saying, I am a part of your body. So, the body which has put to death, symbolically, that was showing the death of Jesus, means I am identifying myself with the death of Jesus, and also I am identifying myself with the resurrection power of Jesus. Hallelujah. So, after taking baptism, and now and then, every month we have a Lord's Supper. In that, we are expressing our faith, saying, taking one piece of bread, that shows I am a small or a piece of his flesh. I am a part of his body. And we are remembering the covenant Jesus had made with the blood covenant. That's why we remember his covenant and will take the vine. Hallelujah. How nice it is. Many times as a church we fail to take up the responsibilities and we are not faithful to our calling. But if we confess and we remember the covenant of Jesus, again we can be restored. So sometimes we may think it's not important to join the church representing ourselves with the body of Christ. But in the Bible very clearly it said in Matthew 7:21-23, Jesus one day is going to say he doesn't like disorder. So that order has to be come through the church, and the church will demonstrate and function as the body of Christ with oneness. Hallelujah. So body is the combination of all functions to destroy the works of the enemy and to pull down the strongholds of the enemy, to domain over all the earth and all created beings. So man has to restore back to his original image of God, should grow into the likeness of God. Hallelujah. So through Jesus our sins will be forgiven. So that is very important. Just to joining a church and doing some ministry, that's not enough. We have to grow into the likeness of Jesus. So when we take back the authority what we are holding is the level of authority whatever we have received from God. So all put together, then we can shake the nations. So that is my passion.
Amen.
I can't stop telling about the church. Always I feel very happy to speak about the church, body of Christ, because I really enjoy the plan what God has through the church, body of Christ. Hallelujah. And always I want to crush the enemy. When we have prayers, usually for warfare prayers, we take direction, and when we come together and when by praying, God shows some of the strongholds of the enemy where that has hold. When he reveals, then that really I enjoy praying together to pull down the strongholds of the enemy. That's a very big story. How God started pulling down the strongholds of the enemy. Going into a place where God shows some of the strongholds while praying, we see that strongholds hold is being demolished. Recently, when we were praying this month, beginning of this month, and God showed there are some snakes and scorpions and jellyfish creature. Some type of creature, they are under the water of the ocean. God asked us to destroy those demonic powers. So, first day when we were praying, I felt our group is not enough. The prayer what we have done, that's not enough. Second day also, there were not many people. On third day, we have taken up the challenge. And when we started praying, we have seen those demonic powers being crushed. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, as a church, when we come together and when we pray, and the demonic powers will be crushed under our feet.
Amen.
Crushed under the feet of Jesus' body. Where is Jesus' body? Where is Jesus' body?
Church.
Church. So when we come together, we can see mighty things happening. Like that, I have many stories and we don't have time. So I will tell While coming to Canada, I was given one assignment. You know what it is? To break one big snake. I don't know what it is. So for this, I can say, when I was traveling, started from my place, India, then God, He said this time, one warfare angel accompanied me. Now also He's with me only. Warfare angel, they are big in size, holding a sword in their hand. Usually that is, I have seen that will go against the many hosts of angels. They will work with us while praying. That's not your job to think about other than God's plan. Look to God. When you look to God, when you take stand in your calling, then you will see the enemy being crushed under your feet. Then you will see the people who are suffering, those who are in need, they will be blessed through you, through you, through you. Hallelujah. If you are depending on your mind, that mind cannot give you the truth. Depend on the word of God. And I have seen many things. One lady, for since 4 years, she was suffering with belchings. Belchings center. Table came up. Huh? Belching. Since 4 years, we were praying a little bit. Is it correct word?
Belching.
Belching. So continuously, usually sometimes those who are having a problem with the demonic powers, so they will have that type of problem. So we were praying and rebuking, little bit she will be okay, again she will be having problem. She has gone for all tests. She was becoming very weak, not able to take food. And she is the member of our church. We were praying and praying and everybody. It took 4 years. One day at home I was praying and why Lord it's not done? Why still she is suffering? Then God asked me to speak to her. No need to pray. Then I counseled her because she is a widow. And when I spoke to her about her life and the hope of her life, immediately her mindset changed, that God. Immediately. Within a second. God knows the solution for our problem. For every problem, there is a solution in Jesus. Whatever the world is facing right now, there is a solution in Jesus Christ. Because He has conquered everything. And we are the answer for the present days. If you place yourself on the calling, what you have, then certainly you are going to help others. That is very, very important. We are gathering like a church, that's not for our sake, but for Jesus. We are supposed to join ourselves as a body. My hand has to join myself, whether that likes or not. That must get attached to my body. It should not detach my nose, my eyes, everything, legs. It should have oneness. Otherwise, it is not going along with the head. That's a great problem. That's a sickness we call. So, body should be healthy. By taking the place what we have. And one lady, Shara, she was working, helping me in the work. And all of a sudden, she developed some thoughts about ministry and she started fearing about demonic powers. Then, while praying, that demon manifested and started speaking and saying, "You know, I am the one I'm causing damage in their business. I don't want to get, I don't want them to flourish. How come she's following Jesus? I don't want her to follow Jesus." Then when I started rebuking that, she started rolling and that left. Immediately, they got the business. Hallelujah. So God is a great God. And one boy is our neighbor, 4-year-old. He has oozing from his head in a spot and on chest and on his hand. The doctor said there's no medicine for his healing. He's not able to walk or anything, and he was on bed. When we started praying, that closed. Three openings, they were closed. Now he could sit on his own. When we had given the other day, before coming here, given my hand, he lifted his leg and he could kneel down and he stood. Hallelujah. With God, nothing is impossible. Hallelujah. One lady, she is very prayerful. She was with me in the prayer hall. Then later, God started using her. She had one problem. One of her leg, that is shorter than the other leg, 1.5 inch shorter. So she will limp a little bit. And one day when we were having prayer 2 months back, I felt, why not we go for creative miracles? Then we started praying. All of a sudden, her leg, within a second, while looking at her leg, it grew. Now 2 legs became same. Hallelujah. Immediately, I've taken her to the shop and I bought sandals for her. In my absence, now she's at my prayer hall and looking after the prayers. So with God, nothing is impossible. So, like that, there are many things are happening. And not only, let's say, past, but present also. God is interested in helping us. Let us pray. Let us look to God. Let us dedicate ourselves to the calling what we have on our life. Let's pray. Let's pray. How do you want to respond to the calling of God? Do you want to say yes to the Lord? Then speak to the Lord and say. It's a God-given opportunity for you to serve Him. This world is not just to have fun and to have good food and to just live physically and end up your life. But we have a purpose on this world to live. Let us realize the purpose and dedicate ourselves to the purpose of God. Thank you, Lord. Whoever you are ready, you just speak to God and say, "Lord, here I am. I will obey you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus." Whoever they are very much disturbed in their mind, they lost peace here. God is touching your mind. Don't depend on your mind or emotions. Emotions are not strong. They are not the, they won't be having any strength. But believe the word. Leave your emotions. Based on your emotions, don't make a decision. But believe in the word of God, make a decision. And tell Jesus, "Lord, I want my place in your body. Speak to me. Whatever you have planned about me, I'm ready to serve you through your body. And help me to crush the enemy under my feet. Mighty things are going to happen, God is saying. Mighty things are going to happen. Whatever happened in the past, forget. And look to the goal and press on to the goal. Press on to the goal. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Whatever way, we are troubling our minds, Lord. Here, we admit ourselves to God, to you, Lord. Help us to come out from our thoughts and our emotions, Lord. Lord, we want to base on your word and to live for you, Lord. Touch each one here, Lord. Bless, Lord. And Lord, the purpose, what you have about the church here, raise them for this season, Lord, so that many will be blessed. Many will be blessed, Lord. Bless each one here, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.